So today we will discuss the concept of this parity generator and parity checker. Okay, so this is the circuit regarding the combination circuits. Okay, these are the examples. So first of all, already we have seen the concept of parity, right? So what is a parity? So it is the extra bit added to the original information in order to detect and correct the errors. So we have seen this case of in the previously. So where we use this parity in the sense, while we are transmitting some information from a source to destination, in that particular scenario, in order to acquire the data integrity and to avoid the errors which occur in the channel, so what we are doing here, we will introduce some or we will add some extra bits to the original information. So where we will add here, we will add these bits to the transmitter side. Right, so at the transmitter side, we will add some extra bits to the circuit, okay, or to get to the information, and that you call it as an parity bits. So in the transmitter side, we use this particular circuit parity generator. Okay, we use this circuit in order to generate the parity bits. Okay, the circuit which is used to generate the parity bits is called as parity generator, and this circuit is mainly used in the transmitter side. Okay, and at the receiver side, you will find this parity checker. You will find circuit called as parity checker at the receiver side. Okay, okay, we see here a parity bit is used for the purpose of detecting the errors during transmission of binary information. So this is the purpose why we are using parity bit. Okay, and the circuit that generates the parity bit in the transmitter is called as parity generator. So at the transmitter side, the circuit that generates the parity bit is called as parity generator. So remember that where the parity generator is existed means at transmitter side, and the circuit that checks the parity at receiver is called parity checker. So parity checker will be available in receiver side. And how to generate or how to identify an even and odd parity in sense? In even parity, the number of ones, if you count the number of ones, it will be an even count. Okay, if you count the number of ones, that will be an even number of ones. Suppose if it is odd parity, then the number of one will be an odd count. So remember that in even parity, the number of ones present in the binary information will be an even count. In odd parity, the number of ones present in the binary information will be an odd count. Okay, count in the sense, you just count normally how many ones are there. Okay, for example, if you take 1, 1, 0, 1. So, if they ask you to identify which parity it is, see 1, 2, 3, total we are having 3 number of ones. So, 3 is an odd number, therefore it is an odd parity. Suppose if you take 1100, here you will have only 2 ones. Here 2 is an even number. 2 is an even number. Therefore, it is an even parity number. Like that, you can count the number of ones. Suppose the count value is an even number, it is even parity. And the count value is an odd number, it is an odd parity. Okay. Now, for example, if you take the consideration of 3-bit message or 3-bit information, then generally you will have 8 combinations. So if you take a 3-bit information, generally you will have 8 combinations. So write down those 8 combinations. Suppose if it is an odd parity bit or even parity bit, we will verify both the conditions. See, when you observe the first condition 000, suppose if you want to verify it as an odd parity condition, odd parity means you should have odd number of ones. But if you observe the message, 3 zeros are there, no ones are there. So you should add one in the information so that it will be observed as your odd parity. And what the same information for even parity? Even parity means even number of ones. So no need to add ones here. Why? Because 0 is nothing but it is an even number. So you can directly take 0 as your answer. So no bit is to be added. So 0. So see the second observation, 001. you are having only a single one. Single one means one number of one. One is an odd number. Therefore, for odd parity condition, no need to add any ones here. So add zero. Suppose if you take one for even condition, then you need to add one here. Why? Because only single number of one is there. If you add one more one, then it will become two ones, so that it will become an even parity number. So add one one here. Like that, for third condition, single one is there. Same, wherever you find single one, it will represent odd parities, zeros, and even parities as ones. Okay, here also single one is there. So odd parity zero, even parity one. Okay, see last condition, three number of ones are there. Three number of ones means three is an odd number. So odd parity satisfied, so zero. Condition satisfied means zero, not satisfied means one. So even parity is not satisfied, so it is one. Okay, remember that when you observe the entire combination, when the asked or the this particular condition is satisfied, it is zero. You should replace yourself with zero. If this set is not satisfied, then you should replace with one. Okay, see here, 0 1 0, single number of one is there. Single number of one means odd parity. Odd parity condition satisfied, that's why zero. Then come here, even parity. Question is odd parity, here it is even parity, so not satisfied, so keep one here. Okay, like that you analyze all the odd parity numbers and even parity numbers. Then by using K-map, this is a K-map, you can find out the equation either for even or odd. Okay, you can find out the equation for this as well as this. Suppose if even parity is taken for verification, so you will get ones. How ones are there? 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 0 1. So replace them, and all them are individual. Already we discussed that if the ones exist like this individually, it is the answer for XOR between all the inputs AXOR BXOR C. So this is AXOR B, and this AXOR B is taken for input as C. So we will get here AXOR BXOR C. This is the even parity. Suppose if you do for odd parity, odd parity also, what you will get? You will get ones here. Here you will get one, here you will get one, here you will get one, here you will get one. So what is the answer for that? AX NOR, okay, AX NOR BX or C. Okay, that you can find out. Okay, this is regarding the concept of parity generator circuit. So if you want to generate an even parity, you can use this diagram. You can use this circuit at your transmitter side. Okay, now we will see the checking, how parity bits are checked. Suppose for example I take 4 bits received. 4 bits received means I will have 16 combinations. So I written all the 16 combinations here clearly, right? And you can check here. Checking means same, you can check for odd condition, you can check for even condition. Okay, right now I will check for even condition. So even condition means first combination consists of no ones, so zero. Second condition of single number of one. So single number of one, it is an odd parity, but we are dealing with even parity right now. So not satisfied means one. Suppose if you see for this fourth combination, 0 0 1 1, two ones are there. Two ones here means even parity. So even parity, now we are dealing with also even parity. So both are same. So condition satisfied, it is zero. Okay, condition satisfied means no need to add ones there. So no need to add ones means you should add zero. That is the concept. Okay, like that you can verify each and every combination for even parity. This is the table regarding even parity condition. Okay, like that you can frame a column aside and you can say it for odd parity also. Okay, you can verify it with odd parity also, no problem. But it, for an example, I took 4-bit message, I will have 16 combinations, and these 16 combinations are verified with the even parity condition, and I got these conditions. Okay, parity error check for even parity. Okay, so and same, by using 16 cell K-map, I got ones randomly like this, and my answer will be AX or BX or CX or D. I said already, when ones exist like this, simply it is an XOR operation between all the inputs AX or B, XOR C, XOR D. So your diagram will be AX or B, CX or D, and these two are given again for XOR. So AX or BX or CX or D is the answer. Okay, like that you can verify your parity checker as well as parity generator. Okay, very very important. Please make a note of this. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.